direct from Studio A of the Howell Cheney Technical High School Media Production Shop, it's HCTV News.
Welcome back to another edition of HCTV News. In this segment, we have some very informational stories for you from our digital media shop. Plus, stay tuned for a music video that was created by Prince Tech students from their sound production shop. First up, Cheney Tech Digital Media and Carpentry students visited the Hartford Stage Scene Shop on October 18th. They got to go behind the scenes to see what the process is of making the sets for the Hartford Stage Company's plays. The visit included a walkthrough of the scene shop as well as details of what the workers there do.
Tuesday, October 18th, seniors in the Carpentry and Digital Media shops visited the 13,000 square foot Hartford Stage Scene Shop near downtown Hartford. The Hartford Stage Company is a Tony Award-winning professional theater in Hartford that presents 7 plays each year. The Scene Shop builds sets for the theater's production. They use around 9 full-time and 8 to 15 freelancers for each production, including carpenters, welders, painters, scenic artists, and digital media technicians. Hartford Stage Director Aaron Black is in charge of all the activity in the Scene Shop.
The basic process starts with a designer and a director, and they will come up with a concept or an idea for a show. And from there, what we will get down here is a preliminary package, a drawing of a ground plan and a section, what they want the set to look like overall. And we take that, we budget it through. From there, we take it into construction, and from there, it goes back into the paint shop for all of its finishing work. So when it leaves this facility, it looks like the interior of a building or the interior of a house or whatever else the designers come up with.
For the carpentry students, it was an opportunity to learn about another career pathway.
Different things, like as there's different machines here I've never seen before. There's many different opportunities in this job, like way different than carpentry. It's a mixture of a whole bunch of shops. I find it kind of cool, like the paint jobs and stuff.
Digital media students also learned how stage sets are constructed and how they are different for video and film sets.
What I found interesting today was how they store all their props and how many props they have. And we opened the door and there were just so many chairs just lined up. It was really cool. I'm very interested in photography, but I feel like as a backup job, this would be a very cool job to do. You get to work with people that do stages and you get to build stuff. And you just let your mind flow, so it's really cool.
Once the set pieces are built, it's a logistical feat to get them to the downtown theater and erect it on stage.
To take a show from this facility downtown, to start with, we have to make sure that we build everything as large as possible, that every piece is complete. We have to take into account all of the logistics of it. We have about 2.5 to 3.5 weeks to build a set down here. From there, we have 4 days to actually install it on our stage itself. So if a show comes down on a Sunday night, we have 5 hours to get the old show out, and then we turn around to Monday morning, we have to start putting the new one in. 4 days later, actors are on stage.
Each set for each show is totally different. Aaron Black says that this makes the job interesting and that it is fresh every time. For the students who attended the trip, it was a great opportunity.
This seems like a lot of fun and just something I would want to pursue a career in.
If you're interested in going to Hartford Stage, then visit the website www.hartfordstage.org. For HCTV News, I'm Kira Franklin.
If you haven't been to a Hartford Stage production, then try to go. I'd like to remind you to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Every morning, students at Cheney wake up and have no worries on what to wear. Since our school has a uniform policy, students have to abide by it and wear clothing according to our guidelines. Let's see what Junior Emily Hansen has to say.
Here at Cheney Tech, we have had uniforms for about 8 years now. We have academic uniforms, and each shop has their own uniforms.
District-wide, we went to uniforms, but we were doing it, a lot of schools in the country were doing it at the time. And it's a lot of it has to do with uniformity. That was probably one of the main things. But like I said, it happened around the country a lot. And most schools in the country go to a uniform nowadays.
I like my shop uniforms better.
I like shop uniforms better.
I like shop because like we are able to wear something like that like makes us feel like we're working instead of sitting down in classes all day.
There are some pros and cons about having to wear uniforms.
People coming to school, knowing they belong, giving them a sense of belonging. But also there are many students out there that it creates an issue because some people are economically better off than others. And this way, nobody feels left out. Everybody looks the same. There's no issues when it comes to uniforms, when it comes to clothing. I think they give the school a sense of unity and pride. People come to school. I mean, it's difficult to get everybody to adhere, but most students adhere. The people, we too much focus on the kids that don't adhere, which is probably 5 to 10%. But most students adhere to it. And I like it. As long as somebody is wearing something that's Cheney Tech, I think, and showing and taking on some pride that they go to Cheney Tech, I think that's fine.
There are uniform regulations and violations.
Basically now I judge, if I'm seeing somebody a lot, yes, then I have a conversation with them. If after I have the conversation, there's not a lot of change, I will refer them to administration. They can talk to them. Maybe we call home, talk to the parents. Then if it continues on from there, then we would probably go to some disciplinary action, maybe a detention, a suspension, something along those lines. But we don't want to be handing out detentions for everything these days. Your ID is something that you sign in with, and the company wants to portray them out there clean cut and advertising their company. So
wearing uniforms is part of an everyday life for a Cheney Tech student. So thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoy another day in uniforms.
Yeah, I do agree with Mr. Stillphone. As long as you wear Cheney-related clothing, you should be good. I have a question for you guys. What's your all-time favorite classic movie? Junior Canfield Heinrich has a new segment all about movies. His first one is an introduction to the classics. Some of the films in the episode are rated R, meaning that you must be 17 to attend unless accompanied by an adult. They contain explicit material some viewers may not find suitable, but the clips, however, are suitable.
Hello there, and welcome to the very first episode of Movie Time. I'm your host, Canfield Heinrich. In this series, I will be talking about films you've probably never seen. I'll also show you why teens your age should see them. Each episode will spotlight a certain topic. For this premiere episode, we'll look at what we'll be covering in future segments. Topics include art house and foreign films, black and white films, Oscar-winning films, controversial and groundbreaking films, and socially influential films. Bored yet? Trust me, you won't be once you see what's in store. You'll also meet some great directors: Martin Scorsese, Stanley Kubrick, Alfred Hitchcock, Federico Fellini, and Francis Ford Coppola, among others. Never heard of them? You will. So let's start with art house films. An art house film, or an art film, is often a serious and independently made film aimed at a narrow audience rather than your average mass market everyday film-going audience. To give you a feel of an art film, here's a clip from the Italian art house film, 8 and a Half.
Avvocato l'ho preso. Ehi, giù, vieni giù.
This clip is from the opening scene of the film. The director, Fellini, fills it with suspense and mystery, exciting and intriguing the viewer. These kind of films are classics of the art of cinema, and if you give them a chance, you may very well enjoy them. This next clip is from a completely different art house film. It is a comedic, upbeat, and sometimes dramatic film. Let's take a look at Roma. What is it with black and white films that turn people off? It's silly. If you think about it, all it is the color of the picture. Just keep that in mind, because my next clip is, yes, another black and white film. This clip is from Citizen Kane, which is considered by many to be the absolute greatest film ever made. Here's Citizen Kane.
Now in complete control of the government of the state, I made no campaign promises, because until a few weeks ago, I had no hope of being elected.
This famous scene from Citizen Kane perfectly captures the raw emotion that is seen in the movie. Here's a clip of another black and white film, this time a classic horror movie. Check out Psycho.
It's not as if she were a maniac, a raving thing. She just goes a little mad sometimes. We all go a little mad sometimes. Haven't you?
One of the most chilling scenes in classic cinema there. Now we move on to Best Picture winners. Here's One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, a classic American film.
You know why none of the guys never told me that you, Miss Ratchet, and the doctors could keep me here till you're good and ready to turn me loose? That's what I'd like to know.
Well, fine, Randall. That's a good start. Would anyone care to answer, Mr. McMurphy?
If you haven't yet seen The Godfather, you're missing a great mafia crime story directed by Francis Ford Coppola. This won the Oscar for Best Picture and was a film focused on organized crime. Here's The Godfather.
Come in. Mwah! You're taking this very personal. Tom, this is business, and this man is taking it very, very personal.
Where does it say that you can't kill a cop?
Come on, Mikey.
Tom, wait a minute. I'm talking about a cop that's mixed up in drugs. I'm talking about a dishonest cop.
Controversy is always good for publicity. One of the most controversial films of its time was A Clockwork Orange. Along with films such as Last Tango in Paris, The Deer Hunter, and The Exorcist, these movies were explicit and utterly disturbing to the audience. A Clockwork Orange, however, went on to become a critical and audience success in the U.S. It earned 4 Oscar nominations, including Best Picture and Best Director for Stanley Kubrick. A masterpiece and a reflection on violence in society, here's a clip from A Clockwork Orange.
Food, all right.
Great, sir, great.
Try the wine.
Thank you, sir. Cheers.
Taxi Driver is another groundbreaking and controversial film. It gave Scorsese the status of a master filmmaker. Here's a famous scene.
You talking to me? You talking to me? You talking to me? Well, then who the hell else are you talking to? Talking to me? Well, I'm the only one here.
Classic. Along with spotlighting art house and foreign films, black and white films, Oscar-winning films, and controversial and groundbreaking films, we'll also be spotlighting socially influential films. Trainspotting centers around drug addicts in Britain in the 1990s. It provides good social commentary on the issue and reflects what life is like for them. Here's a clip.
Choose life. Choose a job. Choose a career. Choose a family. Big television, choose washing machines, cars, compact displays, and electrical tin openers.
Intriguing. Now for our final film of the episode. Here's a clip from a very socially and politically influential film. Another classic from Master Stanley Kubrick, this time about the Cold War. It's called Dr. Strangelove. Let's look at it.
Shoot it off! Shoot with a gun! That's what the bullets are for, you twit!
Okay. I'm going to get your money for you. But if you don't get the President of the United States on that phone, you know what's going to happen to you?
What?
You're going to have to answer to the Coca-Cola company.
Great scene from a great movie. Well, that brings us to the end of the very first episode of Movie Time. Till next episode, this is the end, my friends.
Now it's time for the Cheney Tech Sports Update. Unfortunately, fall sports has come to an end, but juniors Matt Maltica and Eric Card have the story on how each sports season ended. Let's take a look.
Hello, and welcome to the next edition of Cheney Tech Sports Update. I'm Matt Maltica.
And I'm Eric Card. And in this episode, we will look at how the fall sports teams are doing as their season comes to an end.
First off, both the soccer team and the volleyball team have qualified for the Constitution State Conference Tournament.
And I know what most of you are thinking. What about football? Well, the season is now over, and unfortunately, they didn't qualify for the state tournament.
Cheney Tech first-year football coach Mr. Minotti had some opinions about this year's game.
We started out 4-0, and unfortunately, we've lost the last three.
but we're hoping to finish the season 3-0. I've seen a huge improvement in regards to after our first loss, looking at what we had executed on film and what we didn't do well and what we did well, capitalize on what we did well and continue to work on what we didn't do well. You want to reach whatever your potential is as an athlete, you want to reach that. So whatever your ceiling is, you want to make sure you reach that. And how you reach that is not just playing the sport and going out there every day and practicing. It takes a lot during the off season for a lot of the athletes.
Moving on to one of the two teams to make the conference tournament, volleyball.
The volleyball team had the best record in team's history at 16-4. Coach Hume said that earlier he wanted a team to finish with a record of 14-6, and the girls certainly met that expectation.
That's right. And one of the biggest things that got the record was consistent practicing. Junior captain Ijabel Clayton had this to say on their outstanding season.
Teams that have won first and second place in the tournaments before in the past have not been as tough on us this year, but they did give us a run for our money. So it was surprising to see that happen. I was happy with the end result of the regular season because we wanted to make it to the CSC tournament and we wanted to get a record of 14-6.
It was sad to see their season come to an end the way it did in the first round of the Connecticut Interscholastic Athletic Conference Tournament, where they had to face Housatonic Regional, but it was truly amazing to see the progress the girls made this year.
It was. Now switching to the soccer team that qualified for the Constitution State Conference Tournament.
That's right. This season, the soccer team finished with a regular season of a 5-8-3 record. With that record, they had to face the defending conference champions in Harding High School.
They sure showed why they were deserving of the championship from just 1 year ago. Assistant coach Mr. Lego had this to say.
Yes, with their effort and their performance so far, absolutely. The younger players and maybe the less talented players, we've seen a marked improvement in all of them. And our veteran players, our returning players, are showing some great leadership. Solid defense. Solid defense, and I probably add speed into it too. Definitely we could use more help on the offensive end of scoring goals, but a good solid defense has really carried us.
Well, that is all the time we have for this episode. Remember to like and subscribe for more. For HCTV News, I'm Eric Card.
And I'm Matt Motika.
It's great to see that both volleyball and soccer made it to states, but even though football did not make it, they still played very hard throughout the season. Remember how in the beginning of the episode I mentioned Prince Tech was going to be featured in this HCTV News edition? Their sound production shop students, Kyle Shermansky's and Brett Horan, has made a new rap called Rappuccino. It turned out great. Let's see what they created.
Yo, these guys are hilarious.
It's Papa G.
Yo.
Hey, Q, it's Papa G.
What up, yo?
Listen, man, I got another beat. You down to rap for this one?
You asked me to stick a rhyme in the freezer called a rapsicle?
Hey.
Stick it in a cup called a rappuccino?
That's it.
That's what?
That'll be the name, yo.
Aw, yeah, yo.
Yo, can Jacob rap in this one? He's been asking to rap with us. Yeah, yo, Jacob's a pretty yo guy. Listen, there's someone else who wants to rap with us, too.
Who?
Be at the studio in 20 minutes.
All right, yo.
All right, yo. Let's do this, yo.
Check, check, yo, yo.
It's hot like a jalapeno. Got a new recipe for a Rappuccino. Everyone knows that I ain't no cheapo. More saving, more doing like the Home Depot. Home studio, where we make it happen. Mixing all the beats, gotta make you clapping. Better get your feet tapping. Got Q right here, this is where it starts rapping.
Here I am again with number two. Did you miss me? Cause I sure missed you. Wipe away your tears with the tissue. Cause I'm here too. Get rid of any issues, any beef, any cashews. Got a sweet head, dude. Gonna wash the shampoo. But seriously, I'm gonna start rapping. Gonna be wild, so I recommend you strap it. I'm a white boy, don't have any tattoos, and I won't mess with you unless I have to. And if I do, you probably deserve it. Put it on a plate, and I'm ready to serve it. Spit some fire, lady, ain't no art. I rhyme, you straight out from the heart. But I guess it's the end of my first part. We got the next verse, yeah, it's ready to start. They call me Rappin' G cause I'm the father of the gangster. Mixtape is fire, no lie, no pranks to play. No time to waste, write raps, no copy, no paste. No waste of space cause there's a time and a place. And it's right here, right now, my time. So I'm bringing out a new face. See my good pal G, we've been waiting in line. He's a crazy little rapper, we call him Goldmine. His rhymes are so shiny, fresh and new. We got him in the booth so we can rap for you.
Thanks, Papa G, for that introduction. Cooking my rhymes to a gangster reduction. Being a gangster is my religion. Everyone knows how to fly than a pigeon. My rhymes so fire that burned down the kitchen. Made fresh daily, got a new edition. Update, renovate, build it up again. Question's not how, the question is when. It's the right time to rhyme, do it every day. Just keep battling, no one in your way. See, a long time ago, I was a little confused. Told me all my rhymes were straight up due. I ignored them in their hullabaloo. I kept on writing and my fan base grew. Now I'm done with that pit bullshit suit. Take a look at me now, this is what I wanna do. Put your mind to it, you can be a rapper too. Someday I'll rap Pop G and Q.
So there's one more thing before we go.
What?
We got another pal who wants to say yo.
Yo.
His name's Craig G, but we call him the Heat.
The Heat?
His rhymes are so fire, you should take a seat.
Oh.
Just give him a shot and we'll bring back the beat. He's gonna do his rap and the song will be complete. Spits red hot fire just like his hair. Listen to his rap and shake your derriere.
I'm a teacher up before the sun. If you don't have a pencil, you can borrow one. Need a recommendation, I'll write you one. But don't stop to slack until your work is done. Yeah, teacher, I'm writing a quiz. I'll help you succeed in the music biz. I'm crossing my T's, I'm dotting my I's. My rhymes are sweet like cherry pies that I don't need. Keep my sugar down. Organic veggies by the pound. No GMOs in this battleground. Just pop a G and Q with a fire sound.
The Prince students have a YouTube channel of their own with other rap videos they have created. If you're interested, you could look up their channel, which is called Papa G and Q. Sadly, this is all we have for this edition of HCTV News. Don't forget that if you've liked the show, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to make sure you don't miss any other videos or other content from the Digital Media Shop. Signing off, I'm Egypt Bell Clayton. See you next time.